forgiveness of sins. He is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn of every creature. For by him, that is Jesus Christ, were all things created that are in heaven and that are in earth, visible and invisible, whether they be thrones or dominions or principalities or powers. All things were created by him and for him. And he is before all things, and by him all things consist, or all things hang together. And he is the head of the body, the church, which is the beginning, the firstborn from the dead, that in all things, or from all things, he, that is Jesus Christ, might have the preeminence. For it pleased the Father that in him should all fullness dwell. And having made peace through the blood of his cross, by him to reconcile all things unto himself, by him I say, whether they be things in earth or things in heaven, and you that were sometime alienated and enemies in your mind by wicked words, yet now hath he reconciled. To be reconciled means to be made friends to God. You see, we're enemies of God because of our sin. And we see that because of our sin and because of our minds, by wicked words. You see, we've been separated from God because of our sinfulness, our unrighteousness. But God wants to bring you back to himself. That's why he sent the Lord Jesus Christ to shed his precious blood on the cross of Calvary, so that we don't need to go down to hell, that place of judgment. And in the body of his flesh, through death, to present you holy and unblameable and unreprovable in his sight. If you continue in the faith, grounded and settled, and be not moved away from the hope of the gospel, which he has heard, and which was preached to every creature that is under heaven, whereon I, Paul, am made a minister. So this Paul the apostle, was a servant of Jesus Christ. Actually, it means a bond slave. And he was willing to do that which is right in the sight of the Lord. He was a man that was before, his name was Saul. And he was a persecutor of the church of God. He persecuted the Christians until the Lord Jesus Christ came to him. And he was gloriously saved. And the man who said, for this is a faithful saying and worthy of all expectation, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners, of whom I am chief. That man was used mightily of God to preach the gospel of Jesus Christ to many people. And there was much salvation. There were many people who trusted Christ. And they're now, if not already, on their way to heaven. Yes, the moment you believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, you have everlasting life. And you'll never perish. There is no way that anyone can be lost when they believe on the Lord Jesus Christ. So I present the Lord Jesus Christ to you again today. It's the only way we'll ever be in God's heaven. Your sins can be forgiven through faith alone in the Lord Jesus Christ. Wouldn't you like to be delivered from the power of darkness, that is the devil, and translated into the kingdom of God's dear Son? That can be yours today. If you come in repentance toward God, then it change your mind, agree with God that you're a sinner, and believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved.